If you've just watched the first video on assembling the Imperial Knight, then like me, you'll currently have a skeleton and a selection of armour plates. Now this video is going to be the first of a two-part set where I'm going to be painting the model, and I'm going to be starting exclusively on the skeleton for this particular video. Now whilst you're building the model, you're probably going to be thinking about what colour scheme to paint, and I've decided to go for House Tyrannis, which I think is a really cool colour scheme, and I also recognise them from a Black Library novel, so they're the one I want to add to my army. Now, whilst this colour scheme is primarily red, the techniques and advice I'm going to give you will be useful no matter what colour scheme you're painting. So, let's get started. Okay, so the first thing that you need to do is paint the entire skeleton with silver. So that means starting with a base coat of lead belcher. So, as usual, give the paint a good shake. And, well, here is the colour. And then what you need to do is grab a large brush. Now, the one I'm going to use is this one. This is a large dry brush, and it's got, well, a really large brush end on it, so it means I'm going to cover a lot of the model very quickly. So, as normal, I'm going to load the paint up onto the brush like that, and then use a palette to control it. Now, you might find that you need to water the paint down a little bit. If you do that, be careful using this brush to do it, because it does absorb water very quickly, so you can end up swamping the paint if you're not careful. You might find it easier to use another brush to thin it down with water. But load the brush up and grab your model. Pick somewhere to start, so I'm going to begin on the back here. And then all you've got to do is start painting it like this and work that silver into all the details all over the model. Now, this will take a little while to get all the way around it, and as you're going, just keep an eye out to make sure that you're not clogging up the detail with too much paint, okay? Often it's better to do multiple thin coats than one really thick coat, but just keep going till you've covered everything. Now, when you wash the brush, here's a tip for you. You can easily leave little bits of silver in amongst the bristles, so I recommend you wash the brush under a tap rather than using your water pot. So what I'm going to do now is work around the whole model until it's completely silver. So now the lead belcher's dry, we're ready for the next stage, and that's another base colour, it's Balthazar Gold. Now, the idea of painting this on is, well, at the moment, the knight is completely silver, which can be a bit monotonous to look at. So adding Balthazar Gold to it will just help break that colour up a bit and make it more interesting to look at. So I'm going to use a large brush for this stage and just load the brush up like that. And it's just a case of looking around the knight and just picking out some bits of the machinery that you want to be a different colour. So, for example, these bits are a good one to choose, like that. And you have to be fairly neat here, not overly so. It doesn't matter a whole lot if you make a few mistakes. You can always neaten up again with lead belcher. But I'm just going to work my way around the model now, just picking out some bits like this. Now, if you want to add a bit more interest, you can use other metallic colours. So warp lock bronze is a good one to pick. But there's no right or wrong way to do this. There's no definite bits you need to pick out. You can see immediately it's just making it a bit more interesting to look at. So I'm going to work around the model now, and then we'll be ready for the next stage. Cool, so I've finished putting the Balthazar Gold onto the miniature now, and I can see even with just the little bits I've picked out, it's really made a difference and started to bring it to life. You can add more metallics now if you want to, but once you're happy, you're ready for the next stage, which is applying a shade. Now the shade I'm going to use is Norn Oil, okay, and I'm going to be using a lot of this, so I've got a new pot of it. And I'm going to be applying it to the entire model, so you need to get hold of a large brush as well. So the one I'm going for is the large dry brush that I used in the first step. And remember I said it was important that you cleaned it thoroughly, well this is why. If there's still any silver bits left in the bristles, they will contaminate your Norn Oil, okay, so make sure the brush is completely clean before you start this step. Now also, it's going to get messy, all right? I'm going to be using a lot. So if you haven't already, you might want to put down some newspaper, okay? Now, all you do is load your brush up like this and just pick a starting point on the model and just start slapping it on like this and really, really work it into all the details on the miniature, okay? So that you're covering the whole thing. Now, as I say, you are going to use a lot of Norn Oil, and you can see how messy it is already. I am going to get some of this on my fingers. But keep working around the whole model until you've coated it completely, okay? Now, this will take a while to dry, so I suggest you leave it for at least an hour, okay? Because it has to be completely bone dry before you start the next step. You'll be able to tell when it's dry. And also, once you start doing this, I really recommend that you keep going until you've covered the whole model. Okay, don't stop partway through, then pick it up again later, because that can leave a kind of line where it's dried. All right, so keep going until you cover the whole model. Right, so it's been about an hour, and now you can see the miniature's really darkened down now that the Norn oil is dry, and it's started to bring all those colours together as well. So now I'm ready to move on to the next stage, but just want to point something out to you here. See the mess it's made on my table here from all the Norn oil dripping off it? This is why it's so important that you put down something to protect your table when you're painting for this stage. But the next stage is, well, essentially to do the same thing again. Because, you see, I want the metal components of the machine to be much darker than all the metal components on the decoration. So all I'm going to do is repeat the same process. So Norn oil, I'm going to stick to using the large dry brush and just load it up directly from the pot, start painting it on. Now, I'm going for quite a clean appearance on this knight. I want it to look very well maintained. If you wanted yours to look more oily though, you could just trade out this colour for Agrax Earthshade instead, and then you'll get a slightly more grimy looking knight. You could even put some Typhus Corrosion into the recesses if you wanted to make it look especially well worn, but this is going to be perfect for what I want. So I'm going to coat the whole model now and then leave it again for about an hour to dry. Okay, so now that that second coat of Norn oil has dried, well, it's really toned him down, hasn't it? He's looking like a proper heavy industrial machine now. And I'm ready for the next stage, which is to add a dry brush to him. So the colour I'm going to use is Necron Compound, and I'm going to go back to using that large dry brush that I've been using a couple of times now. And I've made sure that it's completely dry, and that's very important for this stage. If the brush is still a bit wet, then it will make a bit of a mess here, so you need to make sure it's completely dry, okay? So what I'm going to do is load up the brush with a bit of Necron Compound and then start working into the bristles like this so that I don't have very much left on the brush. So I'm looking for something kind of like that before I start painting it on. Okay. And what you do is just pick somewhere to begin on the model. So I'm going to start around his face and you just start lightly brushing it back and forth over it like that. Now the brighter silver will start catching on all those raised details and really start to bring them out. See that? His face starting to pop out there. So what I'm going to do now is work my way around the whole model like this and just bring out all those features. You don't need to go crazy. Too little is better than too much. Remember, you can always add some more later, but you'll see that this is going to make a real big difference. So once this is done, well, the vast majority of the skeleton will be finished then, and we're ready just to add a few final details onto him. Okay, so with the dry brushing now done, well, all those details and features of the model are really starting to jump out, aren't they? And what we're on to next is to start picking out some of the details on him to just really bring the model to life. Now, the first of these is going to be all the pneumatic pistons, and I need Runefang steel for this. I'm also changing my brush now to a large brush. So I'm going to load the brush up, put some on the palette like that, and then thin it down with just a little bit of water like that. There we go. So on the model, what I'm looking for are any pistons like these on the legs here. And I'm going to start picking out areas like this, basically the working part that would normally slide back and forth. This is to make it look like it's very clean and, well, very efficient, like it's going to be all working and moving, you see. So I'm going to paint all these bright silver now. And once I've done that, I'm going to get Agrax Earthshade and paint just a bit of it on the top and on the bottom of each one, just for a bit of oil. So I'm going to go and do that now. And then we're ready for the next detail. There we go. I've added some Agrax Earthshade to the bottom and the top of these piston bars here. And well, now they look like working machinery, don't they? Okay, so the next thing I need to do is grab a pot of Abaddon Black. And what I'm going to be doing now is picking out any of the pipes that are made from rubber or something like that. So I'm looking for the smoother ones. So I'm sticking with my large brush for this. And the kind of thing I'm looking for is like this pipe here, this smooth one. So I'm just going to give things like this a solid coat of Abaddon Black. Now also, it's a good idea at this point, seeing as you've got the black out, to paint the eyes as well. So just a good solid coat of black on there, because these are going to be the next things that we work on. And also, whilst you're at it, these heavy stubbers, it's a good idea just to put a little bit of black at the end there, just to represent the muzzle of the gun. Okay, so now that the black's finished, I'm ready for the next stage, which is the final stage of this part of the model. That's the eyes. Now, it's important with the eyes that you paint them very brightly so that you see them clearly through the mask. And it's also important that you pick a colour that works well with the armour of the knight. So in this case, it's going to be mostly red. So I'm going to take green for the eyes because that's a nice complementary colour for it. Okay. Now, this is going to take four colours to do. I'm going to start with a base coat of Caliban green, and then I'm going to layer it with Warpstone glow, followed by Moot green, and then finally just a little bit of white scar. Okay, so I'm also switching to a detail brush because it's very important that you get a fine tip on the brush because this is detailed work. So, starting out with Caliban green, as always, load up the brush and put some on the palette. And I'm going to water this down just a little bit. There we go, that's perfect. And the first step is very straightforward. All you need to do is fill in the eye of the knight like this. So there's that one. And then the other. And I'm just going to give this just a few minutes to dry. Okay, so now that the Caliban green is dry, I'm ready for the next colour, which is Warpstone glow. And this, I'm just going to be painting more towards the middle of the eye than I did with the Caliban. So like this. There we are. So the colour gets stronger towards the middle of the eye. So let's repeat that on the other one. And now the Warpstone glow is dry, I'm ready for some Moot green, which is again just a bit further towards the middle, like that. And then the final part is just a little dot of white scar, just in the middle, like that. Cool. And there we go. Cool, so there we go. Now a huge part of the knight is finished and we're ready to move on to the next stage. So things to remember when you're doing the skeleton of the knight. Make sure you do all the messy stages first of all, so all like the base silver and the shade and all that sort of stuff. And well, as you've seen, the shade is very messy, so make sure you put down something to protect the surface that you're working on when you're doing that part. Now it's very important that you thoroughly clean the brush between each step. Okay, it's very, very important that. And once all that's done, you can move in and add as much detail as you like. But now that this skeleton's finished, I'm ready to move on to the next step, which will be the armor plates. And then after that, we'll make the final assembly.